Okay, hi everyone. Here's a question. It's an opportunity and sunk cost scenario regarding transferring schools. Let's assume you have finished 2 years of college and you have 2 years to go. You found a school that would accept 80% of the credit you have already earned, and the tuition will be 50% cheaper going forward. Now, using completely made-up numbers, let's assume the cost of your education at UWF, where it's assumed you are attending, for the next 2 years would be $30,000 for everything, and you have already spent $25,000 on your education at UWF. Okay, so the question asked, what are the opportunity costs? What are the sunk costs? And in this scenario, can you identify them? Okay, so let's take a look at this. What I've done is I've said, well, let's compare one school to the other. Okay, now past tuition at UWF was $25,000. Okay, that represents a sunk cost. Okay, it's already spent, it's already out the door. Now, going forward, we know future tuition was $30,000 and the new school is supposed to be half of that. So take that number, divide by two, we get $15,000. But there's some makeup costs. So how did I calculate that? I took 20% of the past tuition and said, well, we're going to probably have to spend $5,000 as well. So if you were to compare the two, we would be comparing $30,000 versus $20,000. But is that really all of the opportunity costs? Okay, now I've adjusted the screen a little bit so I can add some more rows. So if we just want to talk about explicit costs, the costs that are known in this situation, if we stayed at UWF, then the opportunity cost would be $20,000, yet it was costing us 30. Maybe it would make sense to transfer. Going the other way, if we go to the new school, our explicit costs are estimated to be 20,000 versus the 30, and that looks like a good decision. However, you also have to place a value on your time, right? You're going to be spending more time going back to school. And by the way, if that was time working, meaning if you were going to school rather than working, then you're giving up the cost of whatever you earned, and that would have to be factored into your opportunity cost. So it isn't quite so clean, and I think you need to consider these factors, even though they may be difficult to quantify. You at least need to consider them, and there are others too. How about the value of your education, particularly to an employer, right? Are you better off having a degree with UWF in terms of finding a job that you're interested in, or are you better off with a degree from whatever that new school is? Okay, so that has to be factored in. And there could be lots of these kinds of intangibles that you really have to place a value on, even though it isn't easy to do it. And then once you have all of these factors, you would add them up and then, lead to which one made the best decision. But I think this becomes an academic exercise rather than one you could really do. And the reason I state that is because, it's difficult to assign a value here other than making a judgment call whether you value it or not. You could assign a dollar number to it, perhaps. But the point of this is it's not so straightforward.